Oven Mitt thanks Cheryl for his present. Oven Mitt inspecting his oven mitt.
Do you like your oven mitt, Oven Mitt? Kitty!
Kitty?
He likes his oven mitt. He pulled it back. Do you like your oven mitt? Five.
Oh my gosh.
You like your oven mitt?
I can't
wait for those posts.
You like your oven mitt?
Oven Mitt thinks that the beautiful tapestry that Cheryl made was for him. But then suddenly Bodacious starts giving the stink eye and comes over. And Oven Mitt decides it's much wiser to depart while Bodacious is in charge. We then go outside so Cheryl can meet the brand new lambs of the day. They were born the day before she arrived. And she really enjoyed chatting to the lambs.
You talk. Yes, you're talking. Uh-huh. Say something else. Uh-huh.
Supposed to go back to mommy, huh?
Yeah, don't blame you. Back to mama. Well, that's a good question. I can't reach that far.
Sweet mama.
There. I can put it in my carry-on.
With the other two died, the twins
died. No, her siblings are still alive and well. It was just easier on the mother, and she was a very weak one, so I minded her.
You got milk right on your forehead.
Cheryl came all the way over from Florida just to feed a bottle lamb, and here she is feeding Ebony and having a nice chat with Pepper and Bear.
You've been around cats so much, I'm surprised you don't. I'm surprised you don't purr.
After feeding Ebony and having a nice conversation, Cheryl decides to try on Dawn Edwards' beautifully felted hat with a Zwartbles edition. And Oven Mitt decides to show how spinning is done. Strings go this way and that way, and that is how wool is spun on a 100-year-old linen spinning wheel. And then Oven Mitt decides it's time to go and have a lovely time getting cozy in front of the hypnotic fire. We then go and visit Smudge. Smudge is Cheryl's favorite. And she and Smudge have had several cuddles over the last few years. And here is Cheryl having a good old chat with Smudge.